Good morning and welcome. I'm Pastor Jim Peters, and you are joining us for worship at Our Savior's Lutheran Church in Topeka, Kansas, on Sunday, January the 10th, the baptism of our Lord. And not only will we be sharing the story of Jesus' baptism in our gospel for today, but this is also a great Sunday for us to remember and to celebrate our own baptism and to pray to God to bless all of his children and to help us to continue to grow in faith, hope, and love. We'll begin today with thanksgiving for baptism. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the fountain of living water, the rock who gave us birth, our light and our salvation.
Amen.
Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are clothed with God's mercy and forgiveness. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning you created us in your image and placed us in a well-watered garden. In the desert, you promised pools of water for the parched, and you gave us water from the rock. When we did not know the way, you sent the Good Shepherd to lead us to still waters. At the cross, you washed us from Jesus' wounded side, and on this day, you shower us again with the water of life. We praise you for salvation through water, for the water in this font, and for all water everywhere. We thank you for the Kansas River, Lake Shawnee, and the water from our taps. Bathe us in your forgiveness, grace, and love. Satisfy all who thirst, and give the life only you can give. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ, our living water, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Please join in our gathering hymn, and if you're using a hymnal, it is hymn number 456, Baptized in Water.
Spirit of the Lord,
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Kyrie eleison. Let us pray. Holy God, creator of light and giver of goodness, your voice moves over the waters. Immerse us in your grace and transform us by your Spirit, that we may follow after your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. And right now it is time for today's children's sermon. So, good morning, girls and boys.
Good
Have your parents ever told you what your first words were? If they haven't, you might want to ask them. But most likely, they were something like Mama or Dada. But do you know what the first words spoken by God in the Bible are? Let there be light. We're going to hear those words as a part of our first reading this morning. They're part of the story about how God made everything. But why do you think light was the very first thing that God created? Well, why do you think light is such a good thing in the first place? Well, it can help us see where we're going, can't it? It helps us to be able to read when it's dark in the room, and it helps us to see what's on our plates when we're having dinner. And when it's really dark out, a little light can sure help us feel better. You know, we can be like that light whenever we behave in ways that help people who are scared and confused. Whenever we show love and warmth to others. Whenever we feed the hungry and put energy into serving Jesus. There's a song that we sometimes sing at church, and you may know it too, called This Little Light of Mine. And a part of that song is the words to encouragement to let our light shine. And in this new year, I would especially like to encourage you to let your light shine to the glory of God. Let's pray. Dear God, we thank you for this day, for this new year, and for the gift of life that you have given to all of us. Help us to continue to celebrate you and to walk in your light always. We ask for all of these things in the name of your Son, Jesus our Lord. Amen.
A reading from Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. Psalm 29 will be read with men on odd verses and women on even verses.
Ascribe to the Lord our God. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength.
Ascribe to the Lord the glory due God's name. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness.
The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord is upon the mighty waters.
The voice of the Lord is a powerful voice. The voice of the Lord is a voice of splendor.
The voice of the Lord breaks the cedar trees. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon.
The Lord makes Lebanon skip like a calf, and Mount Hermon like a young wild ox.
The voice of the Lord bursts forth in lightning flashes.
The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh.
The voice of the Lord makes the oak trees rise and strips the forest bare. And in the temple of the Lord, all are crying, Glory.
The Lord sits enthroned above the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as a king forevermore.
O Lord, give your people. Give them, O Lord, the blessings of peace.
A reading from Acts. While Apollos was in Corinth, Paul passed through the inner regions and came to Ephesus, where he found some disciples. He said to them, Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers? They replied, No, we have not even heard that there is a Holy Spirit. Then he said, Into what then were you baptized? They answered, Into John's baptism. Paul said, John baptized with the baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus. On hearing this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. When Paul had laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Altogether, there were about 12 of them. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark in the first chapter.
Glory to you, Lord.
John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased. The Gospel of the Lord. See if you can guess what the following four phrases have in common. I take you to be my wife from this day forward. I name this ship the Queen Elizabeth. I give and bequeath my watch to my brother. I bet you $20 the Chiefs are going to the Super Bowl. Did you figure it out? They're all examples of what are called performative utterances. This is a concept that comes to us from the philosophy of language. And a performative utterance is a phrase that does something more than just describe something. Instead, they're words that do something, that actually make something happen. A marriage covenant, the christening of a ship, the giving of an inheritance, a wager. You can probably figure out why I started out that way. It's because, just a little earlier, we were all given the most perfect example of a performative utterance, of a word that makes something happen, in our first reading today from the first chapter of the book of Genesis. We're probably used to the idea of God creating everything from nothing, but you might have noticed that that's not what the text says. Instead, it says that the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep. It was a dark, formless, watery, and chaotic space, and it was nothing where anyone could live. And yet, God is separate from this space, for we're told that a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. And then, in a moment, creation begins. Let there be light. Using only words as a tool, God begins to sculpt creation, bringing order out of chaos and light out of the darkness. God begins by creating light, something that is absolutely essential for life. And a word from God makes it all happen. But this and the other days of creation aren't the only times in the Bible when God speaks and something happens. In fact, that happens throughout the Bible. God speaks to Abraham and Sarah about their having a child, and it becomes so. God speaks to Moses out of the burning bush, setting him aside to lead his people out of Egypt to the promised land. And so it happens. God speaks, and the prophet Elijah is given food and strength to travel to Mount Horeb. In today's gospel, God speaks just as Jesus is coming up from the waters of his baptism. And after that, Jesus' ministry begins. Over and over again in the Bible, we learn that God's word is not a dead word locked within the pages of a dusty book on a shelf. No, God's word is active and alive, and God's word makes things happen. And we know that God's word is active beyond the pages of the Bible. For example, whenever someone is baptized, we believe that God speaks and the newly baptized becomes a child of God, a part of God's family, prepared for the future God has in store for them. We have faith that God's word continues to be with us, to guide us and direct our paths, to help us and to shine a light ahead of us, and one day to welcome us home. I know that you're familiar with where this Genesis reading will go from here, from light to the remainder of God's creation, culminating in the creation of humanity, who are made in God's image. And for us, that means that we are blessed to be able to share in a little of God's creative power. We too have control over our speech, and our words can also make things happen. Beyond the wedding vow, the christening, the last will and testament, the bet, we can all use our performative utterances for good or for evil. And as we begin to head into a whole new year, a year which I know we all hope will be a better one than last year, we might want to give some thought to how we're going to use our words in the days to come. In Genesis, God uses divine words to create a good world for us to enjoy. But human words do not always have such a positive effect. If a friend gossips about us, we feel hurt. If strangers yell at us, we feel stung. If people speak to us with disrespect, tensions arise. In the past year, we were made painfully aware that not everyone in our country is treated equally, that some are treated differently, not because of the content of their character, but simply because of the color of their skin, because of the language they grew up learning how to speak, because of the religion they practice, because of their disability, because of their gender. And words have caused them to be belittled, diminished, pushed to the side, degraded, and in some cases, wounded and killed. Do we really think that God approves of this? Well, maybe I'm hopelessly naive, but I still have hope that we can turn this around. And it all begins when we begin to take our words seriously. It might really help things if we can teach ourselves to think before we speak. Our words shouldn't be used to control, to diminish, or to oppress people. But we do it anyway. Words can be so negative that they push us deeper into the darkness. They don't draw us closer to the God who made us in the first place, and they don't help us to follow Jesus Christ. Clearly, we need better words. What we really need are words that express the truth, love, and mercy of Jesus every day. On the first day that ever was, God spoke and brought order out of chaos and light out of darkness. And wouldn't this be a great year if we could only do the same thing with our own words? You know it would. Amen. Thank you. Please join with me as we profess our faith using the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray that the radiance of Christ will illumine the Church, the nations, and all who seek the light. We pray for all people who worship and serve God, that God will welcome us all into his light. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all who have been baptized, that we may be proclaimers of your love and light. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the leaders of nations, that they will strive for peace and justice in this new year. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our own government, that God will provide guidance and wisdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering in the colder weather, that God and God's people will provide warmth for living. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for an end to the pandemic and for health care workers to be restored. Bless and heal all the sick, especially those we name aloud or in the silence of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who have asked for our prayers, and for those we too often forget, that they will know God's support and help. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Hear our spoken and silent prayers, O God of light, and reveal yourself to us through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Once again, I would like to thank you for your offerings and your support of our church. We honestly could not do this without you. If you would like to make an offering to our church today, you can do so online through our church's website. You can also mail your church into the church office, or you can drop it by the office during regular business hours. And again, I thank you so much. God of abundance, all that we have is yours. Receive these gifts and all who gather at your table for the sake of the one who gave himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. I have a few announcements to share with you before we finish. Well, first of all, I just have to say how thankful I am in this new year to have music back. So thank you to everybody who is here for this recording. It is so nice for me to not have to worry whether I'm getting off key singing a cappella. I appreciate you all very much. And as usual, thanks to Javier for all of his work in making this recording possible. I want to invite you to attend Adult Sunday School this morning at 10:15 on Zoom. Pastor Gary Teske is leading a class looking at a recent ELCA social message about Christian involvement in government. I know that there are interesting discussions taking place with this, so please join the group if you can. Also, I want to invite you to join me at, I'm going to be starting up my Wednesday evening study group again, this coming Wednesday at 6:15, on Zoom, and we are going to be looking at the ELCA declaration to people of African descent, which was approved and adopted at the 2019 Churchwide Assembly. I would like to ask you to read that declaration in advance. And there's an explanation of it, too, which I think is worth reading. And the link to that is in the bulletin and in the midweek. Also, you might want to watch the video of the actual presentation of the declaration on YouTube. And you can find the link to that in the midweek. Finally, one of the drawbacks to having worship like this is I don't get to see you that often. And so I don't get to ask you what you think of things and get your thoughts on things. And sometimes I forget to do that. As a case in point, many of you know that we had Holy Communion as a part of our Christmas Eve worship. And I have never taken the time to ask you what you thought of that. And I'd really like to know. Unfortunately, you have a deadline because this coming week, our executive council and worship committee will both be meeting. And I would like to share some of your thoughts about how we did communion. If you're watching this before Monday evening or Tuesday evening, please drop me an email and let me know what you thought about how we did communion on Christmas Eve. May God, who lightens all our paths, accompany you on your journey this day and always. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace. grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Please join in our sending hymn. And if you're using a hymnal, it is hymn number 763, My Life Flows On in Endless Song. Light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.